decode the energy transition, we must tackle unforeseen challenges with a dynamic and pragmatic approach. This means not only relying on a single solution like electricity, but instead utilizing a broad range of technologies in an all-of-the-above approach to successfully arrive at a low-carbon future. Due to technical limitations, not all sectors can be electrified, such as aviation, shipping, and high-temperature industries like steel and cement. To decarbonize these sectors, we must dig deep into the energy transition toolbox to find an alternative solution. This solution is green hydrogen, and thanks to the world-class electrodes here at Nora, we are serving as the launch pad for the hydrogen revolution. I'm Bernard Turi, Market Data Analyst for the Energy Transition and Hydrogen Task Force at Nora. The energy transition can be defined as the attempt to overhaul the current energy system based on hydrocarbons and replace it with a new one based on electricity and renewables such as wind and solar. This is no small matter, and only recently have industry experts, academics, and government leaders come to the realization that it is just not possible to electrify everything. This is where green hydrogen comes in, a green molecule that can reach where electrons cannot and when they cannot. Our electrodes, which for years have served as the industry standard for chlorine production, will also set the bar for water electrolysis. That is, utilizing renewable energy to split water into green hydrogen molecules that can be used, stored, transported, or converted to other fuels. Nora's electrodes are unique by design as they have been developed for over 100 years with three pillars in mind: reliability, scalability, and efficiency. Our electrodes are being delivered to the largest projects around the world, including NEOM, an ambitious trillion-dollar smart city project located on the shores of the Red Sea in Saudi Arabia. The NEOM project will harness desert sun and coastal wind resources to power over 2 gigawatts of Nora electrodes to produce 600 tons of green hydrogen per day and over 1 million tons of green ammonia per year. After NEOM, the second largest project is H2 Green Steel, a 740 megawatt project in the Swedish Arctic Circle that will utilize clean hydropower to make low carbon steel, also using Nora electrodes. We are also involved in other projects that will produce synthetic aviation fuels, a carbon neutral alternative to traditional jet fuels. These projects will combine green hydrogen and carbon dioxide to make a completely green drop-in replacement to the fossil kerosene used today. Due to its similar chemical structure and massive potential impact, we believe that synthetic aviation fuels could be one of the most promising uses of hydrogen in the future. As hydrogen is a new industry, businesses in the sector can be a bit too optimistic about their product performance and future perspectives. Nora, however, has no risk of overconfidence, as we can clearly demonstrate a strong demand for our electrodes through a commanding market share of advanced, late-stage, and funded hydrogen projects. While others are still busy testing and refining their technology, ours is already being sent to work. New talents should start early to find their passion and dedicate themselves to develop skills and expertise in a specific field. For example, I have always been passionate about energy, and now I find myself with many years' experience in an industry that I thoroughly enjoy. As Apple CEO Tim Cook said, "If you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life."